is white as snow. You know, with Allah, you are not allowed to reason with Allah. Are you aware of that? Allah does not let his followers of Muhammad, reason with him. It's like, whatever he says, that's it. You can't reason with Allah. But our God wants us to reason with him. He wants us to search these things, whether they be so, etc. You know, our God is very secure.
Yes. Yes.
And he knows that no matter how we try to reason, we will always discover that he's ultimately right. And that we will be realigned into proper position. Yeah. Reason, the definition of reason means the use of reason, or especially the drawing of inferences or conclusions through the use of reason. An instance of the use of reason, or an argument. So come now, let us reason together. I had a guy last night. I had my Stop Obama sign.
Yes.
Lesson number one, never bring a Stop Obama sign out on Virginia Beach, which is almost half black people who like him. And I guess I found that out last night. But I walked past this guy. He said, Obama's great. And I said, okay, let's stop for a moment. And say, let's reason together, I told him. I said, give me at least four or three reasons why Obama's great. Okay, you say he's great, give me three or four reasons why he's great. And he said, well, okay, number one, he survived 4 years. And I said, okay, so because a president survives 4 years means he's great. And then I reasoned with him some more, asking, what kind of a job do you do? He says he's a caterer, works with food. I said, if he has employees or co-workers that are, you know, co-caterers, and they're not doing a good job, etc. So I reasoned with him based on his job and his co-workers, if he would consider them great, even if they survive for 4 years, even if they're not, like, good employees, you know?
Right.
So he began, so I said, okay, how about another reason? He couldn't give a second, third, or fourth reason. He really said, well, I guess just one reason. So God wants us to reason. It's a word that he has used. Though your sins be as scarlet, they should be as white as snow. Think about these things. God reasoned with the Israelites. And another Old Testament example is the king reasoned with the queen. In Daniel 5:10, we see, now the queen, by reason of the words of the king and his lords, came into the banqueting house, and the queen spoke and said, O king, live forever. Let not thy thoughts trouble thee, nor let thy countenance be changed. So the queen reasoned of the words of the king and his lord. So the king reasons with the queen. Old Testament word, reasoning. Another Old Testament example, very simple. King Solomon was rebuking advice, okay? In Proverbs 9:8, let's read it together. It says, reprove it, not a scorner, lest he hate thee. Rebuke a wise man, and he will love thee. In Proverbs 27, a favorite of ours, often we use as a defense, open rebuke is better than secret love.
Amen.
Very simple. Open rebuke is better than secret love. The word rebuke means to convict, to refute, to confute, and to find fault with, and to correct. You know, if I'm at fault, if I'm doing something wrong, I would hope that somebody would approach me and tell me.
But isn't that judging, brother?
And so, that's the loving thing to do, right? Rebuking in the Old Testament. Now let's look at what the New Testament says about disputing during evangelistic activities. The religious leaders, one example, disputed with Stephen in Acts 6:9, a favorite book of many of us, I'm sure. Then there arose certain of the synagogue, which is called the synagogue of the Libertines and the Cyrenians and Alexandrians, of them of Cilicia and Asia, disputing with Stephen. So they were disputing with him. They were contending with him. Imagine the atmosphere. Disputing with Stephen. Another example from the New Testament is Saul, or Paul, confounding the Jews. Can you say confounding?
Confounding.
That's another exciting word. Acts 9:22 says, but Paul increased more in strength and confounded the Jews which dwelt in Damascus, proving, can you say proving?
Proving.
So he gave a reason to believe that this is the very Christ, proving. So confounding and proving. Let's look at the definition of confounding.
There's a missing word there.
On purpose. I just shortcutted it so it would fit on the screen.
This is very Christ. This is the very Christ.
This is the okay, I see what you mean. Sure, I can stick that in there later. The definition of confounding is to pour together, to commingle, to disturb the mind of one.
To disturb them.
Meditate on that for a moment. Disturbing the mind of one.
Yeah.
To stir up, to tumult, or outbreak.
An outbreak.
Just meditating on these words should literally change our life, change the rest or security that we can have in our evangelistic atmospheres.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
If we can get our college groups and church groups, whoever else is out there doing existing evangelism, if we could get them to just do some word studies on some of these words, certainly, Lord willing, it should change their mind also, as it did when we ran across these words for the very first time years ago. So confounded. Saul increased more strength, confounded the Jews, and he proved. What's it mean to prove? To join together. To put together in one's mind. Someone once said you can't prove anything, but you can give a lot of evidence that demands a verdict of proof. Yeah? I think that's a Josh McDowell quote, matter of fact. Peter expounded with the Jews in Acts 11:4. But Peter rehearsed the matter from the beginning and expounded it by order unto them, saying, etc. So he expounded. We often have to do that, don't we?
Yeah.
We'll make a presuppositional statement, you know, Jesus is the way. Okay. Well, what do you mean he's the way? So we expound on what that means. We give more explanation on what that means. So expounding on stuff. We expound on statements and truth all the time. Of course we have to, because they just don't understand things. So we have to expound on stuff as they allow us.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's hard sometimes when you really want to expound on things with them and they don't want to listen.
Right.
Sometimes they just go boom, 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 10 questions or 10 challenges in one breath.
Right.
Hang on, I'll answer each one for you. Yeah?
Yeah.
But often our desire to serve them through expounding on things is cut off by their anxiousness and unwillingness to wait.
Yeah.